Well, whether right or wrong, it's often said that today's teenagers have got it easy. They have the luxury of information at their fingertips, but they don't have to put in the hard yards. But while this generation might not have the same problems as in the past, they are confronting their own set of challenges. And as the great digital divide grows, parents need the right tools to navigate through this complex age.
Before there was YOLO and FOMO, there was the Breakfast Club.
I know it's detention, but I don't think I belong in here.
Times have certainly changed, and so too have the challenges facing our kids. Today's teens, also known as Gen Z or the digital natives, are part of a global generation more technologically connected than ever before. The average teen spends over 10 hours a day using some form of technology. And parents are facing problems that previous generations didn't have.
Finding that kids now need to be connected 24/7 to the extent where there are, in fact, some kids sleeping with their mobile phones, they're sleeping with their iPads and iPods.
While parents have always been worried about their children's friends, now those concerns centre around social media and cyberbullying. The average age kids are first exposed to porn is now 11, and at least 1 in 10 Aussie teenagers experience cyberbullying. The rapid rise of technology and social media in our households is leaving parents grappling with even more unfamiliar territory.
There's some pretty scary numbers, aren't they? In this week's Spotlight, we're focusing on teenagers then and now. For more, we're joined by social researcher Mark McCrindle and Liz Walker, sexologist and youth educator from the Youth Wellbeing Project. It's great to talk to you both. Good afternoon. Liz, we'll start with you. Would you say it's tougher growing up as a teenager today than it was, say, 20 or even 10 years ago?
Absolutely. And it's, a change that our young people are grappling to understand themselves. I was talking to some just before I came here in the studio and I said, what do you think has changed for you so much, from when I was growing up? And they turned around and they're like, oh, I don't know, pressures. I'm like, the answer's really obvious. And they still couldn't quite get it. And I said, it's in your hands. It's the technology. You guys are wired 24/7. So what used to, WWW used to stand for World Wide Web, I now think it stands for whatever, whenever, whoever.
Yeah, indeed. Did they then realise the effect that that had on them?
No, not necessarily. And I think, sometimes it can be more daunting for parents than it can be for the teens themselves. But obviously parents need to be acutely aware of what they're doing online and really conversing and knowing, are they looking at stuff that's they're not understanding? How can we help them navigate that?
Mm. Mark, what do you see as the major differences? Is it just technology from, say, 20 years ago?
Well, certainly that's been key. No social media back then, and they're now a globally connected generation. But beyond that, they're the most formally educated generation. So you go back a few decades ago and almost half the class left before finishing year 12. Mm. Now 9 in 10 complete year 12 and 1 in 3 go on to complete a uni degree. So they're the most formally educated generation. They're the most globally aware of the issues as well, the technological support. And they're more mobile. They're going to move across more careers. They're moving homes more frequently as well. So teenagerhood has always had a lot of change, even more so these days.
Yeah. Liz, the question is, what do we do about it? Because changing the internet is problematic at best, and often the teenagers are much more astute with technology than we are. So what's your advice to parents about how best to communicate with their teens?
Look, just be on top of your game. Recognise that your teens actually need you now more than they ever have. So, we tend to think that kids need us more, younger children need us more, but teenagers are facing some challenges, mental health issues, social pressures, sexualisation issues. They need us to be on top of our game. And really being aware, getting them to teach us about what's going on. If we don't understand social media, then get online, ask our teenagers to teach us so that we're aware of what they're facing, and making sure that they're connected with other people other than their parents. So who are they socially connecting with that can support them? And likewise as parents, who can we reach out for and ask for support? Sometimes we don't like to acknowledge that, we as parents don't have all the answers, but everybody's in this boat together. So let's reach out and ask for other people who have done a good job before us.
Yeah, maybe we need parental leave for parents as they get into those teenage years where your kids need you so much. Just lost an earring. Looking ahead, be our crystal ball, Mark. What do you see in 20 years' time?
Well, the speed is not slowing down. The speed of change is upon us, and this generation will have to future-proof their careers. They're going to have to be plugging back into education as they go. They'll work across an estimated 17 different jobs in their life, probably five separate careers. So being lifelong learners is going to be key, and just being resilient, being able to adapt to change. We know that by the middle of the century, when they're hitting the peak of their careers, the average home in Sydney will be just over $2 million, median house price. The average earnings will be about $200,000 in that year as well, though. But they're going to have to really save up. They're going to live longer than any previous generation, longer in retirement. They're going to have to start saving now to even buy the home and be prepared for their future.
I'm exhausted just thinking about that. Give me a Bonox. Thanks very much, Mark and Liz. It's good to get your insights.
Thank you.
Thanks so much for having